those two parts are job description and job specification. So job description talks about purely duties, roles, responsibility, every task that a person is supposed to do, handling his or her responsibility, whatever the position has been assigned to that person. Correct? Specification, job specification talks about what kind of qualification, what kind of skill set, what kind of salary, what kind of experience a person holds in order to take care of all those responsibilities and tasks that a person has to undergo. So it just has these two parts that needs to be taken care of. A good job description and job specification is really important for all of us to understand, so that we can actually create job specification no matter which role we are in. Today we are studying HRM, but tomorrow you might be, you know, handling, because some of you are doing BTech. So suppose you have to handle something where, you know, you are talking about hiring an engineer for your organization. How are you going to create a job description? So you will have to specify whether you are requiring a person who has to be hired as a BE, mechanical, electronic, computers, what kind of branch the person should come from, what kind of specialization that the person should have. You know, so the details about what the job has to undertake in an organization is purely called job analysis and job description. So the assignment that I gave last week is a practical experience, and it will give you exposure of creating different or various kind of job description. Because if you join an HR department, if you are handling complete HR for an organization, it is not just one department for which you will be hiring. They can be hiring for multiple positions, for multiple departments. So how are you going to create job description if you won't understand the logic behind or the strategy behind designing all these things? Is going to be very confusing. Yeah? Tomorrow somebody comes to you. Suppose you are in an organization and somebody comes to you. What is the role responsibility that you are handling? What is your job description? How are you going to identify that, and how are you going to speak about it? How will you say about that? Yeah, that's a question to all of you. Everybody is here now in the class, so any one of you can answer. So let's start with Sarvamangala ma'am, right? Ma'am, how will you, explain that, what is the kind of job description and specifications you have?
Job description, I am into training the students belonging to all the branches according to their need, the specification to which they are being hired, accordingly the company specific needs, we have to train the students whatever skill set that is needed for them, that is to be done. And I do have coordination duties with other departments, where I am the department coordinator, where I function as, you know, liaisoning between the department and other departments of the same campus, as well as with the higher authorities belonging to, you know, the higher part of the university, where I have to deal with the our appellate body. So that is to be done. And being into, I have another duty, being the alumni coordinator of the campus, I have got to have a good rapport with all the students who have already passed out. Yeah. That rapport has to be maintained without rubbing them in the wrong way, keeping them, you know, very happy, at the same time getting our things done. And also, we have to register the students not only with our campus, with the campus as a whole. And we have something known as the Alma Connect. I have to coordinate between the Alma Connect and the alumni, where, you know, when any other than the placements that is happening in the campus or in the higher, that is our competitor main campus, the as and when the requirement is coming, I have to let these to be known to the concerned alumni who is needing it. So that is to be made very clear, and in a hold of other responsibility also, it will not be over.
It's a multitasker.
Yeah.
Lot of activities you are doing. So see, this is what she describes about, you know, is her job description. So now for doing all these activities or all the jobs and tasks that he has mentioned, taking care of those responsibility, there should be a skill set that would be required in a person. So she must be hired by the campus because she carries that skill set with her. You know, the skill set can be good, excellent communication skills, experience of over 10 years, 15 years to undertake this particular job. Somebody who has a rapport building kind of a skill set within them, you know, because with students, rapport building would be totally different, but with the stakeholders, managing a reputation is really, really different, difficult kind of a job. You know, the board of trustees and all these people have different kind of expectations altogether. So all these things that she carries in her, that's known as job specification. Correct? So let's take another example. Let's talk about, because Archana is also working, so let's hear from Archana. What's her job description and job specification here?
So my job description includes providing training to Amway direct sellers, sales and imparting sales and product trainings, which includes enhancing their selling skills, enhancing their product knowledge. Also, it includes traveling to different geographies, conducting training need analysis and training need identification of the geography, and planning my trainings accordingly. Then coordinating with different functions so that a specific requirement can be catered for the direct sellers, handling consumer complaint, customer complaints, and it also includes. So I don't remember what all. So it also includes traveling to different territories and conducting trainings for the specified TG. And job specification includes good presentation skills, experience of more than 3 years in training and development, then minimum graduate with a science degree, because the products are basically health and hygiene products. So it requires graduate in science field, and good verbal and non-verbal communication.
So now have you understood the difference between job description and specification, right? So let's hear from Veena also, because Veena has worked in the past. Currently she is on sabbatical, but earlier she had taken care of lot many jobs. So let's, any one of job, Veena, would you like to describe?
I'll do the job description of the last post I held.
Your voice is not coming clear today.
No, it's getting broken.
It's getting, yeah, it's the network, I think, is broken. Not the mic has a problem. I think the internet connection has a problem. It's okay, you can take your time. Yeah, let me just take them through the details. Yeah, then you can give your example. So have you tried to do the assignment that I sent last week? Sabmangla ma'am, Archana had already shared, Veena had shared through email. Yeah, did you get the time to do that?
No ma'am, I did not see it as such.
It was in the case study itself, I mean the PPT that I shared. The slide number 25-26, two assignments.
Sorry ma'am, I it was a very, very tough week. Did not get, not even a single minute, in fact.
No problem. Yeah. So what we can do is, Veena, you have done it. So can you just share your screen with all of us so that, you know, we can carry on with the entire thing. So Archana had done it. We had already discussed that part by the time we joined in. So let's see what you have done and then we'll discuss it.
Good evening, Neeru. How are you? Ma'am.
Yeah, no problem. So Neeru is
good
back
evening, ma'am.
From vacation.
Yeah. How are you, ma'am?
Very well. How are you? You must tell us, how are you? After vacation, how good, rejuvenated you are.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm actually feeling refreshed. Very good. So it was just to refresh myself, because after a long time it was a holiday.
we were having exams in our university, so okay. I had a lot of work over there, meticulous way of conducting the examination.
Right. So see, but you know what happens is when we are doing these practical experience, theory classes are side by side, it will go on. Right. All the practical assignments and activities that I gave you and that we try to do in the class will actually give you hands-on experience and exposure of doing things. If we won't do these exercises, it would be very difficult for you to understand the practicality of HR. Right, Abhi, because right now it is just a start of HR that we are learning. But these two topics are really, really difficult and very entertaining as well. Right. So today, after the discussion of the job description and everything, I will ask all of you to do some exercise on workforce planning also. Good. All right. So let's start it with the beginning. You've done both the exercises?
Yes, all the time.
So just take us through what you have done.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
So basically, it is track the behavioral job description, identify areas that need improvement and implement training program to improve the areas. Yeah. So I have taken the role of a school counselor.
Okay. Essential, can you just move on? We will not call it qualifications, because having excellent listening and problem solving skills will go into the skill set. Another point is point 6 and 7, compassion, patience, adaptability, integrity. Basically, these are values, not really skill set. We can't really call them qualifications, but we can just mention that, necessity of certain skill set would prefer having compassion and patience towards students and parents. Rest is very good. Yeah, let's move ahead.
BGS sports, like we had already discussed. So I have not done any other thing other than I really could not understand. It's written that you have to create a training program as to how to go about it. I really don't know how to go about it. So I didn't do that. I just wrote what are the two methods that can be used for job analysis. Mm-hmm. That is observation and questionnaire to be filled by the customers. And the third one is general manager's operations. I have taken a shipping company, a Mediterranean shipping company. Japan is looking for general manager operations to be part of our Indian management team. The position reports to the director of MS India and is based in Mumbai. The incumbent will be responsible for delivering tangible benefits such as increased vessel productivity and schedule reliability, impactful cost reductions, optimization and standardization of operation processes. responsibility as a head, as a head of India operations, will be responsible for all day-to-day activities related to equipment, maintenance, operations, procurement, and marine operations supported by a team of 50 professionals in India. The responsibility that those were the key responsibilities. In addition to that, we overall responsible of all operation executions in India ports, deliver costs, leadership, terminal productivity, EDI process excellence, and corporate system accuracy as per defined targets. Negotiate contracts with vendors within the position authority limits. Support commercial desk to increase revenue. Establish a strong network with terminals, local authorities, and peers in the industry. People and talent development within the Indian team.
This is related to your job in Navy, so that's really good.
But I went to a shipping company called Maersk
website
and searched for the what are the duties of general manager.
It's
a very, very heavy responsibility actually. And essential skills, deep knowledge of Indian ports and terminals, extensive experience with container shipping operations, learn English and Hindi language skills, good communication and collaboration, proactive and creative, proven leadership and people skills, process excellence mindset.
Very nice.
Then qualification, BTech in any discipline, MBA in operations, BFD qualified, disciples, Six Sigma.
Very good. So see, this is how it needs to be done. So your skill set should be mentioned separately and your qualification criteria should be mentioned separately. Very well done. So I hope now you have understood this task really well, right? How to really write down the job description part. So there has to be a very clear cut title that we have to give to the job that we are writing about, because until and unless we are not going to give a title to that specific job, it is going to be very difficult for somebody to understand. So title is really important. Then after title, we have to talk about what kind of role a person has to undertake to do that particular job in action, whatever it could be. So what are the major primary responsibilities are? In some companies, how we write job description is, we write in two parts. We write about primary duties that a person has to undertake and the secondary duty that a person has to undertake. So like, Sarv Mangala ma'am talked about various responsibilities she is handling in her organization, in her college. So her primary responsibility, because her title says that she's a trainer, so her responsibility generally goes like, training students for this class, doing training need analysis, conducting those training programs. So these are primary roles and responsibility. Secondary roles and responsibility, because she is within the organization for quite some time and she is also an alumni. So her secondary responsibilities are also taking care of all those responsibilities, calling all of them or including all of them, taking care of all the alumni who have passed from the institute, or trying to try and getting in touch with them, building networking and relationship. So these are secondary responsibilities. Rest, obviously, skill set will come and the qualification criteria to do that particular job. So this is how a job description analysis has to be done in any organization. Because now you will go and do an HR's job in some organization. Right? So HR manager or HR executive needs to strategize for all the departments. We are just talking currently about general manager operation. So conducting one job description takes so much of time. You have to then, what you have to do is follow up of. So suppose you have now designed, this is the highest level post for general manager operations. Right now, general manager operations will have at least 10-20 people working under them. So now we have to, from this job description, these roles and responsibility, we have to take certain portion and include the roles and responsibility in the people who are reporting into him. Because he will not do all the task of handling the entire operations department himself. He will also delegate certain responsibilities and roles to people. So that's how the roles and responsibilities will get bifurcated or divided amongst various levels. Right? That's how entire functions, job and roles responsibility come out, and then we get to know. Then we also get to know the gaps, that today we have 30 people currently working in operations department, but because of the job responsibilities and the roles, which are available, there are few responsibilities or there are few roles which are not currently there in the organization. Hence, we start looking for recruitments. We start sourcing those people now in the organization. So that's how the entire role bifurcates into various functions, right? So hope you have understood all that. So let's do another exercise. So Gulshan and Rupesh, now you can participate in this exercise. And we are doing this activity right here, right now.
Yes, ma'am.
So you have, I'm not sure Gulshan have gone through that workforce planning part because he joined the classes late. So giving him that benefit of doubt that he has not understood it. Let's do, I'll give you a small case. So I have not prepared any PPT and all. I'll just say it. You can write it down. And then let's do this exercise right now so that I want to see whether you have understood these two, three topics that we have done or not. Because tomorrow we'll start with sourcing and recruitment. So sourcing and recruitment is very important. But until and unless we have not understood this part, we will not be able to understand the part after this. Correct? So let's do the exercise. Yeah, look excited. As excited as I look. Okay. So let's start with this. So there is an organization which has approximately 375 employees. In various roles and functions. The organization is into trading sewing machines. You understand sewing machines? Jo silai machines hoti hai. They are into trading of sewing machines to various parts of India. The largest department of the organization is import and export department and sales department. Sales and service, you can write. Sales and service department. Out of 375 employees, employees handle sales and service, in various geographies of India. Now the company is planning to go into expansion mode. And they have to hire more people in import and export department logistics department sales and service department and all other functions attached to it. The total turnover of the organization today is 285 crore. Now what you have to do is you have to create a workforce planning for the expansion that the organization is looking at to reach from 285 crores to 500 crores. You have to do a complete workforce planning as well as create. So the second method now that comes to places, we call it interview method. So now how interview method takes place for finding out what a person has to do is, there is a set of questions which is prepared in advance, and then we ask those questions to the individual, that what kind of role they are playing, what are the major tasks that they undergo entire day. And this particular job is done by various analysts, and all these analysts can combine their answers together, earned by various responders. Then they collect all that data, create a complete job's responsibilities, that okay, this particular job, after the interview questionnaire, this is the outcome which has come out of that. It can also happen in group activities. Suppose there is a group activity which happens. So for example, manufacturing setup. In manufacturing setup, there are a lot of people who are doing similar kind of jobs. So then you can sit together. So there would be one interviewer to a group of 10 people. So 10 technicians answering the questions. That's how you collect the data. And that's how you identify what are the roles and responsibility or every task that the person actually do in the organization. Then they categorize these particular jobs and responsibilities in two parts, primary and secondary.
The routine jobs and the secondary jobs that they are doing.
Correct. Third method is questionnaire method. So the questionnaire method is very similar to interviewer, but in interview what happens is interviewer is in front of you and you're answering to somebody. Now questionnaire is a set of questions you send to the people, they answer. And then you collect the data, find out what kind of roles and responsibilities they do, collect the data and design your job analysis, job description. Correct?
It could be also calls, ma'am. Questionnaire calls for feedback.
Yeah, for feedback also. You can do that. This particular slide talks about the method of position analysis questionnaire, which we also call as PAQ method of job analysis. So basically there is a set of questionnaire which is designed, generally 194 questions designed into 6 different concepts. What is the information input of the job? What is the mental processes required to do this particular job role? What is the work output after doing different tasks? What is the kind of relationship people have with various people? So for example, I am a technician, but my roles and responsibility also include talking to the production head, talking to the warehouse manager, kitna product wahan par pahunchana hai. So what kind of relationship building happens in the organization are required? What is the job context and other characteristics of job? So it can be, you know, environmental. Understood?
It is a fixed set of 194 questions.
Yeah, this particular method, full position analysis method. How's that?
Is there some science behind it?
It's a science. There is a research which was done. So after the research, it was found out if we have these six categories and various questionnaires. So there are various questionnaires. When you type on Google, you will find various questionnaires ready made available for 194 questions. And what kind of questions people ask? So that's a research behind that. That is why it is. So people who say that HR is not really a science, it is actually a science. Combination of science and art.
Ma'am, the questionnaire, is it open-ended questions or closed-ended questions?
Both.
Or it can be both?
It can be both. So you can have scales also, that on the scale of 1 to 10, how good or bad is your job is. So various things. How hazardous your job is, or what is the condition of job that is really harmful for you. So manufacturing setup questions will be totally different than the questions for the corporate office. So you can design questionnaire method. In position questionnaire method, then you have the questions readily available. But obviously, you can change it as per the conditions and requirements of the job in your organization. Next method is diary method. Again, diary method is very, very similar to observation method. Whatever observations you have made for various weeks, you are noting it down in a journal form or in a diary form. So for example, let's take this example of Archana's job. So Archana is doing a routine kind of a job. I mean, you know, for various territories, she has to go on and give trainings on similar kind of products. At one point in time, there is a set of products for which she has to introduce it to the other employees. Right? That's what most amount of the job is. So what? How do we do in a diary method is, we note down, we observe Archana, that Archana is conducting training. She's talking about these 7 key points in the training about the product. So that's her job, to give benefits and analysis of what kind of products are there. Then the sales method of how you can actually increase the sales of these products. What are the sales techniques that is required to do with this? So these are 6-7 things that we note down in the diary, that over and over again, these are 6-7 key points that Archana takes care of in her training. So that's how her job analysis being done. So it's a very mixed combination of observation as well as noting it down, which is diary method. Then comes the critical incidents technique. So critical incidents technique generally is useful for understanding behavioral aspects of people doing particular jobs. So because what happens is, routine jobs do not require a specific kind of behavior. But for example, suppose you are in a customer care department. Now your job and responsibility is to manage different kind of customers day in and day out. You don't know what kind of customers you will have a discovery with, you know, in one particular day. So now your behavior can change depending upon what kind of queries or what kind of behavior the other customer is showing to you. That's why you will see that a call center training role, suppose for example, सर्विस कंपनीज के बारे में बात करते हैं, जैसे एयरटेल मान लेते हैं. सो इफ यू कॉल ऑन समबडी एयरटेल कस्टमर सर्विस में, एंड सपोज अर्चना कॉल्स, शी इज वेरी पोलाइट, शी आस्क देम क्वेश्चंस कि मेरे को ये समझ नहीं आ रहा है, व्हाई माय डेटा प्लान इज लाइक दैट, व्हाई माय मोबाइल प्लान इज लाइक दैट, कैन यू मेक मी अंडरस्टैंड, और आई हैव दिस क्वेरी एंड दिस इज बोथ. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सरमंगला मैम गेट्स रियली हाइपर, शी इज अ डिफरेंट डिफिकल्ट कस्टमर, शी गेट्स वेरी हाइपर एंड शी आस्क क्वेश्चंस, दो चार अच्छे से गाली भी दे देते हैं, यू नो, शी गेट्स अब्यूसिव, गेट्स अब्यूसिव एंड शी सेज ऑल दोस थिंग्स. बट नो मैटर व्हाट योर बिहेवियर इज, दैट कस्टमर केयर पर्सन इज सो वेल ट्रेन्ड दैट नो मैटर हाउ योर हाई पिच इज, वॉइस ऑफ पिच इज, और वेदर यू आर रियली अब्यूसिव और वेदर यू आर रियली एरोगेंट, ही और शी विल बी एबल टू स्टिल हैंडल यू इन अ वेरी पोलाइट मैनर. एट द मैक्स व्हाट दे डू इज, दे हैंड ओवर द कॉल टू देयर सीनियर सर्विस मैनेजर, the person who is available on the call center. So this is what their training is all about. So behavioral critical incident techniques talk about that, what kind of critical incidents in your job you have handled which has a direct relationship with your behavior on the job. Right? So handling difficult customers, handling different kind of conflicts within the organization. So for HR managers who are basically into conflict management or grievance handling, this particular thing is really helpful. Right? They can actually note down all the critical incidents behavior where an employee has behaved, misbehaved, or not behaved in a proper manner with other people in the organization. So you note down all their good and bad behavior, and then you match it with the job categories that they have.
It is more in the service industry, isn't it, ma'am?
Yeah,
because
it can
only
be.
When a customer is problem, that they will be contacting the customer's service.
Absolutely. Any service related industry, hotels, you know, travel tours. So this particular method works really well. Yeah. Sometimes in their induction training or orientation training also, they show past behaviors of customers so that, you know, the training. For example, when I was heading the call center, so we used to give these kind of trainings to our employees. The freshers used to come for call center training. So what we used to tell them, that this is what happened in the past with various customers. So in order to give them that is the reason why many call centers record the calls also. And you get that message that your calls is required, is recorded for the quality purpose. So quality purpose का मतलब ये है that we find out the critical incidents.
It happens sometimes because I just remember, you know, when we had given our car for servicing, you know, right. They come and take, you know, all the photographs, etc., both in and out, and they give us also a copy of it. And once the car was delivered after the service, we found out the knob of the brake, you know, it is broken. So I just told them, and he was just flaring up like anything. I said, you know, you're not going to settle it. I just contacted the higher ups. And they told that they'll get something, some accessory from the local market, and they said that would not work because the car is Ford, then we'll have to have the, you know, whatever is meant for that particular vehicle. So I had to wait for 2 days. I had sent a mail to the higher-ups and they called me back, and within 1 week, I got the original thing. So this process has to go around only because of that one person who behaved really bad.
Right. So otherwise, that goes into solved. Very critical incidents. Yeah. So anything critical that they have handled and how they behaved in that particular. So these are the 4 steps that basically is done by the HR person who is managing job analysis part. So first they brainstorm and create list of dimensions of job behaviors. So what kind of job behaviors can be there where people can behave in certain manner. Then list of examples of both effective and non-effective behavior. Then they form a group of consensus whether, you know, each and every incident is categorized appropriately or not. And then they rate each incident according to the value. For example, there are customers jinko kuch problem nahi hai, but they are not able to understand, say because of language or because of, you know, unka background aisa hai that they don't understand ki is mobile plan ke andar kya kya cheezon ko mil rahi hai. So they will just call to the customer care to understand those things. So that will not be really a very typical behavior. So as per the value of that particular behavior, we will give categories that, you know, this is highly critical, this is not that critical, this is least critical. This is how the behaviors are basically categorized. And that's how the job analysis are being formed. So for example, again, you know, suppose you go into the technical area of project management. So the project manager's job is again very, very difficult in terms of managing clients. So their job is not to get involved into the coding and producing web designing and all. Their job is to manage the team who is actually producing the product and being a mediator between the client and the project team who is doing work. So project manager's job again is depending upon the kind of behavior he or she shows to the client and to their internal team. So that's where, you know, you can actually use this particular thing. So again, depending upon what is the nature of the job, what is the nature of the overall organization, you can actually choose the method of job analysis. Right, how it works, conducting the job, then know the purpose, gather information, different kind of books, charts, literature, agency. So you need to know about entire organization in detail, then only you can do job analysis in a perfect manner, and then you can use employee input. Again, depending upon the nature of your organization, you choose the efficient method, whichever works for your company. Completely gather information in a most suitable manner from everybody who is important in the hierarchy. Draft a job description and get supervision. So when you draft a job description, it is not you who can sign it. It is a senior most person in HR department or the functional head who also. Suppose you are hiring sales manager, so sales head approval is also required on the job description that you have created. Apart from HR heads. So this exercise you were talking about, Archana?
Yes.
So now you understood what kind of methods is required? That's the answer that, yeah, Veena ma'am has given. Either the observation method will work.
Yeah. Interview method will work. Interview method. Diary method will work.
Correct. Very true. So good, now you have understood this particular topic really well. very good job done by all of you. So any other questions anybody has? Rupesh, Gulshan, Veena? No, I think not. Veena, understood all that? I have not gone through the exercises that you've done, but I'll go through it tonight and will share my inputs. So Mangala ma'am will share it by tomorrow. So for tomorrow, what I need for you to prepare a little bit is just read about what are the ways of sourcing candidates. In the last 1 month classes, we have spoken about these very nonchalantly, you know, not really in an organized manner, but I have spoken about all the methods various times. But I would like you to do a little bit research, you know, 15, 20 minutes research. Just take out. It won't take too much of time. You can do it on your mobile, do on Google, and read about the topics so that we can go into the technicalities really fast and I can give you real-time exposure. Because what we will do is, I'll try and do some sourcing in front of you, because that's what my firm basically does, so that you understand how the sourcing is being done. Right? We will take up some real life jobs and then we will start the sourcing. Okay? So because the sourcing recruitment is going to be very practical, there is hardly any methods to understand. It's, you know, majorly it's all about practicalities. So that is a little homework that needs to be done. Okay.
Is it a mock drill?
Sorry?
A mock drill?
Yeah, it would be a mock drill. Rupesh, Gulshan, any questions?
Oh, man.
No questions. So before we end the class, you know, what are the skills do you think that would be required to do workforce planning and job analysis? What do you got from these lectures? What is the skill set that would be required in an HR manager or strategic HR person?
Analytical skills.
Analytical skills, for sure. Yes. Good.
Observation. Strategic planning.
Strategic planning is a function, yeah. Negotiation, yes.
Yes.
Not understood. Your mic is really not working well today. The reading skills, okay. So reading what?
Problem solving skills.
Problem solving, for sure, yes. Good. Reading and acquiring knowledge. Yeah, correct. So we call it research, basically. So researching about that particular topic. Because, you know, when you move from industry to industry, there are various kind of exposures that you get to know about various industries. Because one industry is totally different from two. So I have worked in call center, manufacturing, IT and textile, majorly. So four different kind of industries and four totally different kind of experiences altogether. Different kind of hiring and recruitment techniques that you have to incorporate. Different kind of workforce planning that you need to incorporate. So understanding and researching about the industry is really, really important. Majority of the people, knowingly or unknowingly, do not acquire that kind of knowledge. And that is the reason why many organizations advertise about their job, or that's how they write their job descriptions, saying that they will prefer somebody with a similar industry experience, because they know that many people do not have that kind of an exposure working in various industries and understanding that. But people working in finance and HR have that particular, you know, benefit that no matter where they go, they can actually start using the principles of HR and finance in those companies. But for HR, if you want to go into business HR, knowing industry is really important. like, you know, we did this workforce planning for this company which is into trading more some particular product. So totally different setup than a manufacturing setup. So for example, continuing the same example, we remove trading company from this exercise, and suppose we now take that it is an manufacturing company. The company now manufactures their own product. So what are the departments will get removed from the entire workforce planning? Or we need to additionally add what kind of departments would change?
Manufacturing.
So currently, suppose the same example, you know, of company now producing sewing machines. And they are not acquiring it from, they are not sourcing it from various sources. So now how the demography or the entire workforce planning will change of the organization? What will change?
Import-export department will not be required here.
Correct. So import-export department, that huge numbers will not be required. We will only require if we are now exporting it to other countries.
Mm-hmm. Or importing some parts of the machine.
Or importing some parts, correct. Yes. What else will not be needed? Would you now require that large, huge warehouses everywhere in so many cities?
No.
You won't.
No. Not needed.
Correct. You might require it at key points.
You may.
Yeah,
so we need more of engineers and others. We need more engineers and others for,
correct,
you
would need more engineers.
Manufacturing.
Correct, because now we are doing production of some products yourself,
yeah.
So you would require a production engineers. Department, correct, completely, with engineers.
And technicians, of course.
And technicians, very well.
Then we need... once the product is done for testing, we need a separate department to
quality department. Yeah.
Yeah, quality department.
Quality measure, quality department, the planning department, right?
Yeah. Then, of course, certification from the government,
very
whatever true. Certification is to be, yeah.
Yeah.
Then, since it is into manufacturing, I feel they need the workforce also should be the basic necessity for the working people, etc., to be maintained.
Of course,
and like
might
in
increase
the...
because now we are manufacturing,
yeah,
the product. So from,
yeah,
these many units, now the unit will also enlarge.
Yeah.
And for producing that, now you need more people, not just in sales and service department, but also in...
where the basic facility has to be assured,
right,
for the, they are into the manufacturing department.
Sales department will not really become that small. It is the major function of the company would be to sell. You see? But yeah, that would not be 70% of the organization. That will reduce to 40, 45, 50%.
Yes, yes.
So that's how the demographic of the entire organization changes. Now you will need more labor workforce. Earlier, labor workforce was not there.
Yeah, labor.
So now you will need labor who can actually produce certain things. So not really very highly skilled people, but people who are unskilled or semi-skilled who can actually produce the products themselves in the manufacturing setup.
Related issues regarding laborers and others,
yes,
also.
So HR department's role will change, correct. They would now,
yeah,
need people more for conflict management or industry,
yeah,
relations. Yes, that would be HR. So within HR, now the role changes. Earlier, you were actually not doing the industry relation thing with manager, workforce and all. So now you need their welfare officer within the manufacturing setup. You need people who can manage HSC, which is health, safety and environment within the organization. That part also comes into, yes, labor officer is a mandate. So various things changes, you know, that's how the entire thing. So various industry, when you move, similar example, similar kind of revenue, similar product, but only the way the industry works changes so many things. Good, so now you have understood this really well. So just do this homework for tomorrow, and then we are good to go for sourcing and hiring tomorrow. Yeah. All right. Any other questions that you have? Or shall we call it a day?
It's not yet.
No, awaaz nahi aa rahi. You can write down. No, we are not having professional skills class. That's over. That was only for a month. So we might do professional skills classes at the end of this 5 months. After we complete HR, then I think again you will have it. So we'll then talk
Excuse
about,
me, ma'am.
Then we'll talk about. I'll just complete this. So then we'll talk about how to write your CVs, interview skills, and all that. Yeah, Gulshan, now you can say. मैं भूल जाती हूँ इसलिए मैंने कहा मैं कंप्लीट कर दूँ।
What is the what is the tomorrow assignment? What will be the tomorrow assignment, ma'am?
What you have to do tomorrow is sourcing के बारे में आपको पढ़ के आना है. That how when we are in HR, how can we do sourcing of candidates? Hiring से पहले हम एक चीज करते हैं sourcing, मतलब ढूंढना लोगों को किस तरीके से हम लोग काम करते हैं. किस किस मेथड से किस किस टेक्निक से हम सोर्स करेंगे वी विल टॉक अबाउट दैट टुमारो
वी विल हैव टू मेक अ केस स्टडीज ऑन दैट
पार्ट यू डोंट हैव टू डू एनी केस स्टडी कुछ केस स्टडी नहीं बनाना है व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू जस्ट हैव टू रीड अबाउट इट
ओके
ऑन गूगल इफ यू टाइप वेरियस टेक्निक्स ऑफ सोर्सिंग दैट यू कैन डू
ओके थैंक यू मैम
Meeru is connecting again, so I'll just tell her about what we are doing today and then we'll end. So you can leave the class if you want to. It's just that Meeru is again joining, so I'll just describe her. Alright, good night. No, I think she's not able to join. It's okay, I'll speak to her over the phone. All right, thank you everyone. Bye bye. Have a good day. See you tomorrow.
Bye bye.
Hi everyone.
Hi.